Good evening. It's 8 o'clock. The top headlines tonight. Lots of drama as farmers could be evicted from different protest sites by tonight. Uttar Pradesh's ultimatum to farmers vacate the protest site, the Delhi-UP border. Security stepped up at other protest sites as well, including the Delhi-Haryana borders. Could the farmers be evicted tonight? Police, heavy contingents of police are now at all the various protest sites. The opposition will boycott the president's address tomorrow over farm laws. Meanwhile, the West Bengal Assembly also passed a resolution today against farm laws as the few BJP MLAs walk out chanting Jai Shri Ram. The Prime Minister speaking at Davos says we already have 2 made in India vaccines. More will be made soon. He also says India's self-reliance will reshape globalization. $55 lakh vaccine doses from India have now been shipped to other countries. We ask, why not allow vaccines by the private sector too, in the private sector too? Meanwhile, the good news, no COVID cases in 147 Indian districts for the last week. Now 67% of India's cases are only in Kerala and Maharashtra. Foreign Minister speaks on China's aggression, says China was willing to breach peace and tranquility. He says the India-China relationship is now at a crossroad. An opening zip of a young girl is not sexual assault under the tough anti-child abuse law, rules a judge at the Bombay High Court. It's the second judgment which is controversial by the same judge. Earlier she had said that you need skin-to-skin contact to actually constitute sexual assault under POCSO, that groping a child's breast is not enough. Now she says opening a zip is not sexual assault under POSCO. The Sensex falls below 47,000 today. The market's worried over a possible COVID cess in the budget. Our Tamil Nadu election report. Will the Jaya legacy matter as the sparring over it begins? And Arvind Kejriwal announced at the AAP National Council meeting that AAP will contest in 6 states in the next 2 years. They include UP, Uttarakhand, Gujarat, Goa, Himachal Pradesh and Punjab. Well, the latest news coming in right now at 8 o'clock. It seems extremely likely that farmers could be evicted from 4 different protest sites across Delhi today. Uttar Pradesh administration has already said that farmers must leave the protest sites by tonight. That's the Delhi-Ghazipur border. But also at the Singhu and Tikri border, we've seen, which is with Delhi-Haryana, we've seen that the security has been increased there manifold. There's heavy Delhi police contingents here. Also, JCB has been used to dig up a road at the Singhu border, at the Tikri border also. There is huge security. Farmers Union leader Rakesh Tikayat has said that he's ready to face bullets, he's ready to be hanged, but he will not leave the protest sites. But it's likely to be, well, a situation where there's not going to be much choice as a confrontation is building between police and farmers, with the already Ghaziabad administration saying they've been given orders that the farmers must leave tonight. Here's what Rakesh Tikayat, Farmers Union leader, had to say just a short while ago. So let's just go back to those pictures. So we saw this dramatic build-up from the morning and also notices being posted at various sites saying that farmers must vacate. This is from Ghazipur. That's the Delhi-Ghazipur border. We know that farmers were evicted also from the Baghpat site overnight. Now where the farmers will be evicted from Ghazipur, this is where Rakesh Tikayat and his branch of the Bharatiya Kisan Union is. But also heavy police deployment at the Singhu and Tikri borders. Other news coming in that in the FIRs filed in the Red Fort violence, the police have now used the tough anti-terror law. That's the UAPA. So that really is now going to be the next focus. Lookout notices have also been issued for farmers involved in that, which the Punjab Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has actually condemned. Let's just look at how the whole confrontation between police and farmers have built up today.
Chaos and tension at the farmers' protest site in Ghazipur on the Delhi-UP border. A massive police presence to evict the protest site. The farmers adamant they will not budge.
नहीं होगा किसान देश के किसानों के साथ में धोखा है ये नहीं होगा धरने चलेंगे यहीं चलेंगे धरने.
A peace yatra was taken out by farm union leaders from Singhu to Sonipat as the leaders scrambled to salvage public goodwill in the aftermath of the Republic Day violence. But the backlash is building. A massive build-up of security forces at the Delhi-Haryana, Singhu and Tikri borders today. A possible premonition of action. Despite the huge police cordon, tensions rose as a group of 100 managed to make their way in to demand the farmers be evicted. They claimed to be locals, their ideological affiliations clear in their slogans.
अपना जो भी प्रदर्शन है अपने स्टेट में जाके करें हमारी दिल्ली के सिंघू बॉर्डर को खाली करें जहां से 15 अगस्त को हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी झंडा फहराते हैं वहां पे जाके इन्होंने झंडे को उतार के अपना झंडा लगाया.
Only after farmers protested asking how these men were allowed in did the police clear them. Elsewhere, Haryana police tried to seize back control of highway toll plazas from farmers. Farmers had taken over the plazas, ensuring free passage to anyone passing through.
जिन लोगों ने जिन ग्रुप्स ने लंगर लगा रखा था उनसे अपील की है प्रशासन ने कि अभी चूंकि आपसी सौहार्द बिगड़ने का खतरा है आसपास के कुछ गांव के लोगों ने भी इनसे आग्रह किया है कि यहां से धरना उठा लिया जाए.
In UP too, the crackdown on protests after the Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister ordered the eviction of farmers. In Baghpat, in western UP, the administration got a protest site vacated. They claimed to resume highway work. Baghpat Additional District Magistrate Amit Kumar Singh said, the NHAI had written to us because their work was getting obstructed due to the protests. We had come here to get the site vacated. The protesters, including a few elderly people, left the site peacefully. But yet, support trickles in. Some farmers in Haryana are still going to Singhu to join the protest.
हमारा जो भाईचारा है वो बना रहे जो सरकार ने तोड़ने की कोशिश की है उसको बना के रखना है हमने और जो 26 जनवरी पे वहां पर जो कांड हुआ है उसकी हम घोर निंदा करते हैं.
NNDTV ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट.
Well, let's go across live now for what's happening from Ghazipur and Singhu. Now, Ravish, pehle abhi Ghazipur mein, what is the situation there?
आज देखिए गाजीपुर की अगर तस्वीर हम दिखाएं तो ये मंच है और यहाँ पर जो राकेश टिकैत हैं वो धरने पर बैठे हुए हैं और उनका ये कहना है कि वो पानी भी अपने गांव से लाकर पिएंगे और धरने से नहीं उठेंगे. वो इस बात से नाराज़ हो गए कि जिस तरीके से 6:30 बजे इसी मंच पर जब राकेश टिकैत ये कह रहे थे कि वो शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से गिरफ्तारी देंगे तब यहाँ पर इस मंच पर तमाम सारे पुलिस के लोग आ गए थे. इस बात से लेकर वो नाराज हो गए और अब वो धरने पर बैठे हैं. धरने के अगर मैं दूसरे साइड की अगर हम बात करवाएं अगर हम दूसरे साइड में आपको दिखाएं तो जो राकेश टिकैत के जो समर्थक हैं वो भी अब यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं कि रजाइयाँ लेकर बिस्तर के साथ में यहाँ पर बैठ गए. हम राकेश टिकैत से बात करने की कोशिश करेंगे क्योंकि सोनिया दोपहर को जिला प्रशासन के साथ में राकेश टिकैत की इस बात पर सहमत बन गई थी कि शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से इस धरने को ख़त्म करेंगे लेकिन उसके बावजूद जो है वो अभी फिर से राकेश जी यहाँ पर धरने पर बैठे हुए हैं. राकेश जी से बात करने की कोशिश करेंगे. राकेश जी ये बताइए कि बात आखिर कहां पर बिगड़ गई. पहले तो आप कह रहे थे हाँ कि शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से समाधान खोजा जाएगा.
प्रशासन यहां पे आया और बातचीत करी और कहा कि जो लोग गिरफ्तारी देना चाहते हो ये गिरफ्तारना स्थल अब अवैध घोषित कर दिया यहाँ से ये हटना पड़ेगा. उनका ठीक है मगर हमारे लोगों की क्या गारंटी है कि ये घर तक सुरक्षित जाएंगे.
क्यों मतलब कि आपको ऐसा क्यों नहीं लगता है कि सुरक्षित जाएंगे.
बीजेपी के लोग यहाँ पे 500 लोग बीजेपी के नीचे, उनके विधायक यहाँ पे,
विधायक भी हैं,
विधायक
कौन से विधायक हैं,
क्या नाम उसका, ना सुनील शर्मा।
अच्छा, ये विधायक और समर्थक यहाँ पे मौजूद,
समर्थक मौजूद और नीचे लाठी लेके किसानों को मार रहे हैं। तो ये बीजेपी के खिलाफ आंदोलन था, ये उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार के खिलाफ आंदोलन है, उनके खिलाफ मुकदमे दर्ज नहीं होंगे। कितने वे लोग थे यहाँ पे, क्या लेने आए थे, किसानों के साथ में मारपीट करी है।
तो अगर मामले दर्ज होते तो आप अपना धरना उठा लेंगे?
धरना नहीं उठाएंगे।
तो आखिर इसका क्या रास्ता क्या होगा, क्योंकि प्रशासन तो कह रहा है कि आज रात तक इसको हटाना है,
करवा दो खाली, करवा,
आप नहीं उठेंगे
ना।
तो अभी स्थिति जो है वो तनावपूर्ण बना हुआ है, अभी
क्या करेंगे अगर पुलिस
बैठे हुए हैं, इनका कहना है कि
राकेश टिकैत जी क्या करेंगे, इफ द पुलिस ट्राई टू फोर्सफुली इविक्ट हिम, द पुलिस ट्राई टू फोर्सफुली टेक हिम, व्हाट विल ही डू?
राकेश जी ये बताइए कि पुलिस अगर यहाँ पर धरना को खाली करवाना चाहेगी तो आप लोग क्या करेंगे, आखिर क्या आपका कदम होगा?
हमारा कुछ नहीं, लाठी बजाओ, हमारा गोली बजाओ।
अच्छा, तो इससे तो हिंसा हो सकती है, क्योंकि आपके समर्थक अभी भी यहाँ पे?
नहीं नहीं, क्यों हिंसा होगी, मारो, हमारा बीजेपी के लोग धरना खाली करवाएंगे।
नहीं, लेकिन आपके प्रशासन के साथ में बातचीत हो रही थी, आप
तो नीचे बीजेपी के विधायक और ऊपर प्रशासन।
अच्छा,
हाँ, ये षड्यंत्र क्या है?
ये राकेश जी बोल रहे हैं कि हम अभी धरने को खाली अगर करवाना है तो एक टकराव की स्थिति हो सकती है, वो कहते हैं वो यहाँ से उठेंगे नहीं। तो अभी फिलहाल सोनिया यहाँ पर हालात जो है वो तनावपूर्ण है, क्योंकि इस मंच के अगर दूसरी साइड में मैं आपको दिखाना चाहूँ तो एक सड़क को क्रॉस करने के बाद में RAF और PSC की तमाम सारी फोर्स लगी हुई है, सैकड़ों की तादाद में जो पुलिस फोर्स है वो यहाँ पर लगी हुई है, और DM ने यह साफ तौर पर कह दिया है कि आज रात तक इस धरना स्थल को उन्हें खाली करवाना है, क्योंकि ऊपर से आदेश हैं। तो अब देखना होगा कि आखिर इस टकराव के बीच में कैसे कोई कैसे।
That's a very important point, Ravish, because just to summarize for our viewers in the south of what Ravish Ranjan was saying, what the very important point is that there's been a clear shift from what the policy was on the 26th of January, where it was let the farmers protest peacefully. Now the Uttar Pradesh police and the Delhi police seem to be in no mood to continue. They are going to evict the farmers there, at least at Uttar Pradesh. Those orders are clear. Let's go across to Singhu, where that's now the under the Delhi in that sense. Arvind, what is the situation there? Because there's a complete shift from 26th January to 28th January on what the police stand seems to be. They're not in the mood, clearly, orders on the top to take any more, to let things go out of hand or to risk the violence that we saw that day when the police exercised maximum restraint and so many policemen were injured.
Yeah, Sonia, what we are witnessing here at the Singhu border is a massive deployment of security forces here. Delhi police personnel, along with the several companies of the Central Armed Police Force, have been deployed here at the Singhu border. Though the police officials are calling it as a routine security arrangement, but what we witnessed today was all the lanes, all the arterial roads and the lanes that connected to the main stage of the Singhu border, Singhu protest sites, have been blocked through the cement blocks by the police officials here. So though there was a resistance from the protesters, from the farmers here, while the police tried to block the entry and exit gates or connecting to the main stage of the Singhu protest site, the police went ahead and blocked all the lanes, and the police still maintains that it is part of a routine security arrangement. So unlike what we are seeing in Ghazipur, where the UP police is trying to forcefully evict all the protesters, all the farmers there, but this is not the situation here, at least at Singhu border. What we are being told is that the police have already issued notices to all the leaders, farmers, union leaders, asking their response within 72 hours. So what we are being told is that the police will be waiting for their response within 72 hours, and based on their response, the police will take a legal action. Before that, there won't be any kind of a crackdown. That's what the police officials here
so
are telling us.
So that's an important distinction. What's happening in Uttar Pradesh and what's happening in Haryana, in a sense, because that's the Delhi-Haryana border, that's the Delhi-Uttar Pradesh border. In Uttar Pradesh, it's clear out tonight. In Haryana, the Delhi-Haryana border, it's wait and let them answer the notices, but no chances of that heavy police deployment we can see there. So in a sense, farmers unions now on the back foot. Remember that two farmers unions have already left these protests, but meanwhile politically several opposition parties led by the Congress have said they will skip the president's address tomorrow for the second year running. They say this is because of the farm laws and how they were not allowed to speak when they were passed.
So the budget session of Parliament is going to begin tomorrow. It will be held in two parts, and tomorrow is the President's address. Of course, the budget is going to be presented on the 1st of February, but a fair amount of politics is also at play, where the opposition has now decided that they are going to boycott the President's address tomorrow. There is an interesting omission in this list of the opposition boycott, and that is the Bahujan Samaj Party. Mayawati has decided that she will not join the opposition's boycott. Apart from that, statements are going to be released, joint statements are going to be released for farmers by the opposition parties. In fact, we are also hearing that 16 opposition parties, including the Congress, have demanded a probe in the centre's role, what they say is the centre's role in the Republic Day violence. As we told you, budget session is going to be held in two parts. The first part begins tomorrow and ends on the 15th of February, and the second part begins on the 8th of March to end on the 8th of April.
Meanwhile, the other big headline tonight, the Prime Minister addressed a special Davos session, which was virtual, the Davos agenda, where he stressed that India has provided the world two Made in India vaccines and there will be more soon.
WEF में सभी को तसल्ली होगी कि अभी तो सिर्फ दो मेड इन इंडिया कोरोना वैक्सीन दुनिया में आई है, आने वाले समय में कई और वैक्सीन भारत से बनकर के आने वाली है। भारत की आत्मनिर्भरता की आकांक्षा ग्लोबलिज्म को नए सिरे से मजबूत करेगी।
Well, and more good news on India's COVID numbers. The health minister today said that there's been no new COVID cases in some districts for a week, and that actually nearly 70% of India's cases are now in just two states, Kerala and Maharashtra.
If I have to give you a picture of the districts, 147 districts in the whole country, they haven't seen a case of COVID in the last 7 days. 18 have not seen a case in last 14 days. 6 have not seen a case in last 21 days. And 21 districts have not seen a case in last 28 days.
So India's vaccination drive continuing. We're now at over 25 lakhs. But Vishnu, now our export diplomacy also picking up.
That's right. Bhutan, the Maldives, Nepal, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Mauritius. Let's bring up the map. Seychelles, Sri Lanka, Bahrain. Now, these are the countries that India is providing the Serum Institute manufactured Covishield vaccine free of charge. And India is now also going to be providing vaccines to Oman, Caribbean nations, Nicaragua and Pacific Island states as well. It's called vaccine diplomacy, which is great since the pandemic is certainly a global struggle. Let's take a look.
खोप अभियानको सुरु गर्न पाउँदाखेरि म अत्यन्तै उत्साहित पनि छु. मैले खोप लगाए र मैले यहाँहरूलाई पनि यो खोप लगाउनको लागि आह्वान गर्छु.
ভালো লাগছে যে মানুষের মানে আমি একটা ভলান্টিয়ারলি এই কাজটাতে একটা মানুষের অংশগ্রহণ করার জন্য উদ্বুদ্ধ করার জন্য অংশগ্রহণ করতে পেরেছি. It was a good feeling and there is no, I didn't feel anything bad right now.
Who's Foreign Minister Jaishankar's first public comments on the India-China relationship, which he said is at a crossroad today, and choices that are made will have profound repercussions for both nations and the world.
The events in Eastern Ladakh last year have so profoundly disturbed the relationship because they not only signaled a disregard for commitments about minimizing troop levels, but also showed a willingness to breach peace and tranquility. Significantly, to date, we have yet to receive a credible explanation for the change in China's stance. The LAC must be strictly observed and respected. Any attempt to unilaterally change the status quo is completely unacceptable. The India-China relationship is today truly at a crossroads.
Quick look at other news. Well, holding a young girl's hands, opening her pant zip is not sexual assault. According to Justice Pushpa Ganidriwala, a Bombay High Court judgment which she gave, it says this is not sexual assault under the tough anti-child abuse law. Remember, this is the same judge who last week had that controversial judgment which said that you needed skin-on-skin contact, that just groping a child's breast, according to her, again doesn't qualify for the tough anti-child abuse law for sexual assault under that. However, the Supreme Court stayed her earlier judgment, and this judgment is likely to be questioned as well by activists. That time the centre as well had objected in the Supreme Court. A quick look at the markets. Well, the market's decline continues for the fifth day ahead of the budget. The Sensex down by over 530 points, closing at below 47,000. The Nifty down as well. The main reason apparently being a worry over a COVID cess possibly in coming up in the budget, and also settlement of futures and options segment of the market has led to some volatility. Well, our election focus, Tamil Nadu special. How much does the Jaya legacy really matter, and the whole fight that has erupted over her memorial?
Late Chief Minister Jayalalitha's Poe's Garden residence now turned into a memorial. With elections by May, Chief Minister Edappadi Palaniswamy wants to leave no legacy of the AIADMK leader open to any claim. On Wednesday, EPS had formally opened this 79-crore phoenix-like monument for Jayalalitha. The day Jayalalitha's friend and ousted AIADMK chief Sasikala was released from a Bengaluru jail after 4 years. This happened even as Sasikala's nephew, TTV Dinakaran, claimed that with Chinnamma, as Sasikala is called, out of jail, that would pave the way for Amma rule in Tamil Nadu. Dinakaran had managed to win Jayalalitha's R.K. Nagar constituency, defeating the ruling AIADMK candidate, but has not been able to get the two-leaf symbol.
He has come out. Sir, when and after getting the advice of the doctors only, we will decide about her when to take back to Tamil Nadu.
EPS has not just shut the AIADMK door on Sasikala. He yesterday expelled a functionary who put up pro-Sasikala posters.
AIADMK is like a banyan tree which is already fully grown.
Only Edappadi is a very good leader. Sasikala is Amma.
Despite Team Sasikala's claims of sleeper cells in AIADMK, the ruling party has remained intact over the last 4 years. But after Dinakaran's Chennai victory, his party could not win even a single seat. Now with Sasikala's release, both sides are flexing their political muscle for Jayalalitha's legacy. In Chennai with Suresh, Sam Daniel, Find the TV.